So let me start with the next slide. So next we have instruction set. So an instruction is a binary pattern designed inside a microprocessor to perform a specific function. The entire group of instructions that a microprocessor supports is called instruction set. What does this entire word mean? I have that we have a total number of 17 instructions. 74, sorry. We have a total number of 74 instructions, which are bifurcated into five groups. For example, the first group is data instructions. The second group is logical instructions. The third group is arithmetic instructions. The next group is control instructions. The next group is branch instructions. So all these five categories will give you a total number of 74 instructions, and collaboratively it is called your instruction set. This is called your instruction set. So each instruction is represented by an 8-bit binary value. So if you are using data instruction, in it you are using 8-bit of binary value. These 8 bits of binary value is called opt code, OP code, which is called operation code or instruction file. So what is an operation code, OP code? What is an operation code? So operation code, which is to be performed, that is called OP code. So your OP code will be either add, it will be either subtract or multiply. So these are your OP code. And what does the operand means? Operand is a data. It can be a data or address on which that operation is to be performed by the op code. For example, here you have written add b. So add b is an instruction. What will be the result of this instruction? You minimum need two operands. So one will be the automatically accumulator. So what will be the result of this instruction? The contents of accumulator will be added with the contents of register B, and the result will be stored for accumulator. Right? So I am repeating again, what will this add B do? The one operand will be residing in accumulator, and the another one will be in B register, which is given in the instruction itself, add B. So here add is your OP code, operation code. Add is your operation code, and AC and B are two operands. These are your operands. So let me show you one more example. Subtract SUBC. So what does this instruction will do? It will subtract the contents of accumulator from the register C, and the result will be stored back to the accumulator again. Right? So next we have addressing modes. So the first of all, we have a definition. Addressing modes are nothing but various formats of specifying operands. how you specify your operand, that is called addressing mode. So this is your operand, this is your operand 1, this is your operand 2. How you can specify the operands? So addressing modes are the various formats of specifying operands. So these are called addressing modes. So in 8085, we have a total number of 5 addressing modes. In 8085, we have a total of 5 addressing modes with us. The first is called direct addressing. The second one is called register addressing. The third one is called register indirect addressing. The fourth one is called immediate addressing. Last but not the least, we have implicit addressing. Right? So I will not discuss all these addressing modes here. We will be discussing these addressing modes in lecture itself. Right? So you just need to remember the names of these 5 addressing modes which are used for 8085 microprocessor. So let's get started with the instruction set of 8085, that is classification of instruction set. Classification of instruction set. So I already told you earlier that we have a total of 74 instructions which have been bifurcated into 5 parts. So the 5 parts are shown in the form of PPT in front of you. So the first one is called data transfer instructions. The second one is called arithmetic instruction. The next one is called logical instructions. The fourth one is called branching instructions. The fifth one is called control instructions. So let me start with data transfer instructions. So data transfer instructions, these instructions move data between registers or between memory and registers. For example, R2 to R1. So here R2 will be acting as your source and R1 is acting as your destination. So this instruction specifies that the data movement is done between R2 to R1. Right? So if I write MOA R2, this means that the data value which is written at M of A, M means memory. So in second example, the data movement is done between memory and register. In case of first example, the data movement will be between register to register. Right? So this is register to register data transfer. This is called memory to register data transfer. So these instructions copy data from source to destination. While copying, the contents of source are not modified. So your contents of source will not be modified. For example, R1 is having 100 value, R2 is having 200 value. So before the instruction, let's suppose your instruction is move R1 comma R2. So what does this instruction will do? It will move the contents of R2 to R1. And after the execution of this particular instruction, the contents of R2 will be 200. It will remain same, but the contents of R1 will be altered to 200. before the execution your contents are 100 in R1. After the execution your contents will be R1. That is why it has been written in PPT that while copying the contents of source are not modified. So here R2 is your source and R1 is acting as your destination register. So here you can see that in table move is the OP code, that is move is the operation code, and operands are RD, RS. The first operand is RD, RS, where RD stands for destination register and RS stands for source register. Right? In second example, move RD, M. It means that the contents of memory will be moved to the destination register. The contents of memory, that is M, it will be moved to the destination register. So RD stands for, so this means that move RD, M. The contents of memory, which is written with the help of M, it will be moved to the destination register. So here M is your source and RD is your destination. Right? In next example, it is written move RS, M. So here RS is the source register and the contents of source register will be moved at the memory location. So here memory location is your destination. So this instruction copies the contents of the source register into the destination register. The contents of the source register are not altered. If one of the operands is a memory location, its location is specified by the contents of HL registers. What does this mean? If one of your data is residing in M, then the contents will be written with HL pair. So wherever M word is specified, HL register pair will be used, right? Suppose the memory location is 2050H. This is your memory location. So HL will point to this memory location. So HL is a register pair. HL is the register pair. So below are the three examples. Move B, C. So here the data movement is between register to register. That is the data of C will be copied to register B. In second example, the data from memory location M, it will be moved to B. In third case, the data of register C will be moved to memory location M. So move is the simple data instruction. So the very first instruction, which is very, very simple, is move, MOV. Next, MVI. Here, MVI means move immediate. Move immediate, the syntax is RD, data. In MVI, the data is always written in the instruction itself. Right? In case of first instruction, the data which is written in the instruction itself, it will be moved to the RD. For example, MVI A comma 57H. So here 57H is the data which will be moved in A. So here 57 is the data value. Immediate means the data is present in the instruction, right? So in case of second example, MVI M comma 57H. So this means that, for example, M is your memory location, which is written with 25250H. So here, this is your 250H. So the data is 57. So 57 will be stored at M because the instruction is MVI M comma 57H. Again, this 250 is your HL, that is register pair. I hope the concept is clear to all of you. So this is your second data transfer instruction. Next we have LXI. Here L stands for load. Here L stands for load. X stands for register pair. And I stands for immediate. Right? Just wait.